on insurance.
So today we are going further in the topic of drugs and magic remedies act and rules. In the last lecture we discussed about the advertisements will be any form of the information or any form of the notice or any info that was used to be provided in the form of a notice or a circular or a banner or in the form of a light or smoke. So coming forward, we will be discussing about the appropriate advertisements. So not all the advertisements are to be published or advertised to the public. So there are appropriate advertisements also. And firstly, we will be discussing the advertisements that are relating to the drugs. So majority of the drugs are meant to be prescribed only through the registered medical practitioner. So majority of the drugs are not to be advertised so that the public can buy and take the medications on their own. So it is strictly prohibited. So first is the all those drugs which can be used in the miscarriage of a woman or in the prevention in the conception of a woman. These drugs, these kinds of drugs are not to be advertised at all, because what will happen that the woman will start consuming these kind of medications which can lead to their either health or even death also. So firstly, miscarriage in women or prevention of conception in a woman, these kinds of drugs are not to be advertised at all. So secondly, this is the correction of the menstrual disorders in women. So all the drugs that are used for the correction of menstrual disorders, these drugs are also not to be advertised at all and should not be shown on any forms of social media or any form of television, radio or FM. So this is also comes under the category of prohibited advertisement. Third is the maintenance or improvement of capacity for sexual players. So you have heard or seen such kind of notice boards or some form of wall paintings that for improving the sexual or human player medications, especially you can see these kind of advertisements are shown in the bus stand areas or in the railway station areas. So basically these comes under the prohibited advertisements, and these kind of advertisement regarding the maintenance or improvement in the capacity for the sexual players for the sex, these kind of advertisements are also prohibited one. Lastly is the drugs that are used for the purpose of diagnosis, prevention, cure of a certain kind of diseases like blindness, blood poisoning, cancer, diabetes, deafness, gallstones, kidney stones, pneumonia, blood pressure, cataract, heart attack, and the list is endless over here. So basically these kinds of drugs are not to be advertised at all. They should not be shown to the public, because majority of these drugs are these drugs cannot be used for the prevention or cure or mitigation of the disease conditions. So as you know, heart attack cannot be cured, blood pressure cannot be cured, cancer is non-curable, so gallstones cannot be removed. So these kinds of drugs should not be advertised, and moreover there are no such kind of drugs which can cure the heart attack or can cure AIDS or cancer and menstrual disorders of the woman, or they can be used in the case of poisoning or in the treatment of blood pressure and all that. So basically, if we talk about the overall lecture of today, the basics is that the prohibited advertisements, all the drugs that cannot be used to cure a particular disease, these kinds of drugs should not be advertised at all, because people will start taking these kinds of drugs at their own and may risk the human life. So again, I will be discussing these points. So all the advertisements that are related to drugs which can be used by the public in the miscarriage of a woman, in the correction of the menstrual disorders in the woman, maintenance or improvement of capacity of human beings for sexual players, and diagnosis, prevention of blindness, blood pressure, cancer, AIDS, and another category that comes which is the advertisements directly or indirectly giving the false impression regarding the true character of the drugs. These drugs, these should also not be advertised at all. And the advertisements related to magic remedies, like the advertisements relating to some sort of a tantras, mantras, some sort of a kavach, these advertisements are also strictly prohibited under this act. So this is all for today's lecture. Thank you.